ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله شهادة تنجينا من عذاب النار ويدخلنا الجنة من غير سابقة عذاب ولا عقاب وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه أشهد أنه قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة ومحى الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين فصلاة وسلاما على عبدك ونبيك محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. ويقول الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم عن أبي هريرة قال سبعة يظلهم الله في ظله يوم لا ظل إلا ظله: إمام عادل، وشاب نشأ في عبادة الله، ورجل قلبه معلق بالمساجد، ورجلان تحابا في الله اجتمع عليه وتفرق عليه، ورجل دعته امرأة ذات منصب وجمال فقال إني أخاف الله، ورجل تصدق بصدق فأخفاها حتى لا تعلم شماله ما تنفق يمينه، ورجل ذكر الله خاليا ففاضت عيناه، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. أما بعد، all praise to Allah, all praise to Allah, the one, the only, the one who should be worshipped. I bear witness that He is the creator of this universe and He is the one who should be worshipped. I bear witness that Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam is His messenger. True mercy sent to us. If you follow His path, inshallah, we'll be in Jannah. Amma ba'd. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, always when he sits beside him, he's trying to reward everyone. There is a hadith stating that Abu Bakr in Jannah, Umar in Jannah, Uthman in Jannah. He specifies names. I heard your footsteps in Jannah, O Bilal. And he says why. And so on and so forward. So many of the Sahaba, khayru khayr, and he gives the khayriya to someone. And for example, Ukasha, when he's saying 70,000, I give khutbah before 70,000, they're going to Jannah without questioning. And Ukasha is sitting beside the Prophet, said, make me one of them. And the Rasulullah said, you are one of them. So quickly. But what's for us? I wasn't there. My son here wasn't there. What's for us? My brother here wasn't there. What's for us? Oh Prophet, you forgot about us? Did you? No, he didn't. Wallahi, he didn't. He loves us. He sent us this hadith. This beautiful hadith puts the categories. Not names, categories. And I'll take only three of them. There are seven, I'll take three only. Because I cannot handle the seven in one khutbah. It's huge. And even the three, I'm just summarizing them. The first one, and the second one, and the middle somewhere. The first one is Imam Adil. The hadith of Abu Huraira, he said, seven categories will be shaded in the shade of Allah. Shaded. Why we should need the shade of Allah? Because the sun will be so close. Imagine how far is the sun, my son? How sun? I always say that. Science? How far? It's 93 million miles. 150 million kilometers. And if you go to a places like the desert, not the desert, here even. Here in Canada, when it goes to more than 30, we're sweating, we're dying. I don't lie, when I came here in the first year, and they said, the weather is 35. And the ambulances, you see everyone, oh, we're going to houses. And what's happening? 35, what's 35 here? I'm coming from 40s and plus. What are you talking about? But here, because now I know, after 20 years, I know that when it goes to above 35, it's a problem. People die. Now imagine the sun is 1 mile up above us. 1 mile. Above our heads. 1 mile. Above our heads. And there is no shade. Except the shade of Allah. Don't you want to be under the shade? Yes, we want to be under the shade. How to be under the shade? Try to go to one of these categories. Seven. Subhanallah, and it applies to any of us and all of us. Let's go to the first one. Imam Adil. And everyone, when we hear that, Imam Adil, oh, you mean the president, the prime minister. Yes, yes, and the king. Yes, yes, he is Imam Adil. Yeah. But are you Imam Adil? Let's see. To create an Imam Adil, I'll go back to Imam Adil after a while. To create an Imam Adil, to have a good man up top, how to start, O Prophet? شاب نشأ في طاعة الله. شاب نشأ في طاعة الله. Then you have to raise up in ta'ah. You have to work with Allah. You have to understand Allah. Everyone, if now I talked about, and everyone will smile now. If I talked about Fortnite and how the games, or why the Raptors lost the day before yesterday, and the Lakers lost too, everyone said, oh yeah, yeah, he's watching the games. He's watching. But if I ask you, what do you know about the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam? What do you know about how to pray? What do you know about shurut al-salah? Arkan al-salah? How can we pray? We just pray. We need to learn. We have to understand. We need to invest some time with our youth to make them better. To make them good Muslims. For themselves. Why? To be shaded. There is a shade. Give him the reward. The shade. And does Allah's shade. If you are brought up as a good Muslim. How hard it is? It's not hard. You need just to invest some time. As you're investing in watching a game. Or investing in watching, playing Fortnite. Right? Playing Fortnite. I see some faces smiling here. Fortnite or NBA? What do you play? Or Call of Duty? How far you play? Oh, you invest some time. Oh, yeah, I forgot about FaceTime, Snapchat, Twitter. You invest a lot of time. Maybe, okay, maybe I'm old now. Like me, I'm over 25. Some people like me over 25. But still, when you came here, when I came here, when I was 1 year old, when I came here more than 23 years old, I invested some time to learn English. You learn English, right? No one of us knew perfect English, like Canadian English, until you come here. Then you invest some time. You invest some time reading the Quran, understanding the Quran, reflecting upon the Quran. Then really, we need to understand that. We need to work with that. It's good to memorize the Quran. It's good to memorize the Quran. I believe even it's better to read the Quran and understand it. How did I get this from Sayyidina Umar? He said, every 10 ayat, we try to understand every part of this ayat, what do and not to do. Yeah, it's good to memorize, but it's better to understand, to reflect, than to raise someone to be shabun nasha fi ta'atillah. Why? After that, we'll be inshallah talking about iman. But where to raise the shab nasha fi ta'atillah? How? How can you do it at home? At home, sitting in his room, and you're sitting in your room, and you're tired and exhausted? No, you have to bring him to the mosque. That's why I ask everyone, when you see some youth playing, enjoying, running in the masjid, don't rush him out. Don't kick him out. Oh, I want to pray. I want to read the Quran. Get out. No. Try to be his father. Try to understand and reflect. Make him sit down. Make him understand. Give him some time. Try to understand that it's hard. In these days, to sit and read, even for us as adults, over 25, it's hard for all of us to sit and read and understand and reflect and to be good Muslim. How about a youth 7, 8 years old, 9 years old? It's very hard. But if you want to have Imamun Adil, what's the bounty of Imamun Adil? I'm back again to Imam. Now I took Shab, youth, who came in the sake of Allah working, understand, you don't have to sit 24-7 in the mosque. Do you want to play Fortnite? Go ahead, enjoy. I'm not saying, want to be NBA? Do it. But how long do you watch? How long do you play Fortnite? You have 2 weeks off. How long time do you sit in front of TV? I'm asking for 10% of that time. Compute it yourself. I'm not going there. You give it how long? 5 hours? 4 hours in front of TV playing? Half an hour? 5 hours, half an hour. Reading the Quran, understanding, hearing a khatib, hearing Nu'man Khan, hearing someone who teaches you Islam. Very important. Now the YouTube, you can put it in the background and just hear it. Understand it. Now, what is the benefit of that? Imamun Adil, again, back to Imamun Adil. Every one of us can be Imamun Adil. Every one of you. And me. How do you treat your wife? How do you treat your family? How do you treat your son or daughter? Do you love them enough? Do you show your love to them enough? Do you do what's good for them? Not what they like. Two different parts. What's good is different than what they like. Because what I like to eat chocolate and ice cream and sit on the couch all day. What I like. But is it good for you? It's not good. Because you'll gain weight, you'll be obese. No. Then what you should take is learn. Teach them how to do. It's your job. It's your job. كَفَى بِالْمَرْءِ إِثْمًا أَنْ يُضَيِّعَ مَنْ يَعُولُ. It's the worst sin you do. The worst sin you do is you, the people who are depending or dependent on you, you lose them. You lose them. It's very bad. It's your job. You'll be questioned. I always say there are seven bridges on the hellfire. Seven bridges. Seven bridges. I'll say them because I want everyone to memorize them. It's very good to know what are we coming to. The first bridge is الشهادة, الصلاه, الزكاة, الحج, الصوم. Five. Sixth bridge is what? حقوق العباد. All these previous bridges, five bridges, it's between you and Allah. Praying, fasting, whatever. شهادة. I say أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله رسول الله. Done. You do it once in your life. Salah, zakah, hajj, whatever, five pillars, it's between you and Allah, nothing there, no one can see you. But subhanallah, subhanallah, with that being said, now comes huquq al-ibad, huquq al-ibad. My son here will say, oh, the khatib has a loud voice today, oh Allah, revenge him, get him, wear this in the sixth bridge. He would stand in the sixth bridge waiting for me. Oh, the khatib didn't smile when he saw me. I'm not thinking about the father or the mother, by the way. I'm saying about the khatib. Imagine that everyone here would say, oh, get him. I want hasanat from this man. You want hasanat from everyone, even your parents. Oh, I sneezed and my father didn't teach me how to say, Yarhamukumullah. That's hard. Yes, that's it. He didn't teach me. Oh, my father didn't teach my mother how to treat me well. Now it's not you. No, yeah. You'll be responding to someone else. Oh, you saw me, and I didn't pray. I didn't do good, and you didn't tell me. Yeah, what is this? What are you talking about? From where did you get this part? I always like the dalil. I always, wallahi, when someone tells me that, where is your dalil? Don't say something without a dalil. The dalil of this is we read it every day. What is the ayah of the Quran? رأيت الذي يكذب بالدين. سورة المعون. رأيت الذي يكذب بالدين. فذلك الذي يدع اليتيم. ولا يحض على طعام المسكين. لا يحض على طعام المسكين means that I'm paying zakah. I'm paying zakah. Didn't say that. وَلَا يَحُضْ. I see you not paying zakah, I'll be questioned. I see you not paying zakah, and I know now you're not paying zakah, I'll be questioned. What is the relation between all of what I said in Imam Adil? It's all related. You are responsible for everything. To be an Imam Adil, you have to work. My brother here is doing a job outside, taking care of the cars with a smile and taking care of the people. My brother, he is recording the khutbah, trying to be perfect in everything. This is how it's his job done. He took it. By the way, the volunteer work, sometimes I always say it's harder than the normal work. The volunteer work is you ask for it. You ask for it. You want it. Then you have to do it perfect. The same way in everything of your life. No one asked you to be a father. No one asked you to be a brother. Did someone ask you to be a brother? You chose that. Someone would say, I didn't choose to be a brother. Yeah, I chose to be a father. I married a woman and she got my kids, but I didn't choose to be a brother. Yes, this is part of the test. I'm sorry to tell you the message. It's part of the test that you, every one of you, looking at me, and I'm looking at you at the same time. Are you a good brother? And who's your brother? Oh, my brother, you know, my brother who I came from with my father. I'm sorry, it's not true. I have to give you the hard news. I am your brother. He is my brother. Every one of you is my brother. مؤمن المؤمن إخوة. إنما المؤمنون إخوة. We are brothers in the sake of Allah. We have to treat ourselves. If every one of us treat every one of us like a brother, we will lie, Allah will lie, our life will be different. If my sister in the back needs something and she knows that his brother is here, it's different. If my son is sitting and I'm taking care of him, it's different. The approach is different. But the problem we deal with each other, it's not my problem, it's his problem. No. The sixth bridge is standing in front of you. Take care, you'll be there. And you'll be questioned. And imagine your son, your daughter will be running. I need your hasanat. Oh, by the way, to finish, the seventh bridge is silat al-arham, connection to relatives. But always I adore the sixth bridge because I believe every one of us will be standing there for a long time. Because it's a very hard bridge to pass. Allah will forgive what's between you and him. But us, we don't forgive. We like to get more and more and more and more hasanah. I have million hasanah, I need 1,000,001. And 1,000,002, why not? Why do I leave hasanah with you? That's why I always tell my youth here, always when you're praying, between the sujood, you say Subhan Rabbi Allah, and you sit between the sajda, and what do you say? Allahumma ghfir li wa li walidayya wa li ashabi al-huquq alayya. Oh Allah, forgive me, forgive my parents, because they are the most important. Forgive me, forgive my parents, and forgive everyone I owe. Everyone I owe. Wa ashabi al-huquq alayya. Everyone I owe him something, give him some hasanat to be happy with me. That's how it works. That's how to create, to think about Imam Adil. 3 points, I'm not going more. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ لَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا يَا فَوْزَ الْمُسْتَغْفِرِينَ. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. أما بعد, I said before about always we like to have an extra life. Extra life is very important. What am I talking about? Extra life? Can we get an extra life? I'm not playing a game here. What are you talking about? Extra life? We're not playing Fortnite. Come on. What's extra life here? No, you have an extra life. You can get an extra life. You can ask for an extra life. How can I get an extra life? From the hadith of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. How did he get? إذا مات ابن آدم. If you die, I'm dead. No more lives, I cannot. But no, you have an extra life. Get it. 3 things you do, you get an extra life. What? إذا مات ابن آدم. قد عمل من الثلاث. What? صدقة جارية. علم ينتفع به. ولد صالح يدعو له. 3 things. I believe all of us can have 2 of them. All of us can have 2 of them. Maybe علم ينتفع به. We are not الشافعي or Abu Hanifa or Ahmad ibn Hanbal or any of them. We don't. We cannot have the power to write books and give these things. Then I'll pass on that one. Okay? I'm not one of them. Then the other 2. What? So it's easy. Everyone. Kids and money. Kids. If you have kids, this is, you teach them to make istighfar. Like I said, Allahumma ghfir li wa ladayya wa ashabi al-huquq alayya. 3 things. Allahumma ghfir li. Oh Allah, forgive me. Forgive my parents. Teach them. It's your job. Teach them. Filli wa ladayya wa ashabi al-huquq alayya. Everyone I owe. This is giving hasanat to everyone. Then the last one is, which is the easiest of all. Easiest of all. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, sorry, the ayah said, Bismillah ar-Rahim, وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ أَحَدَكُمُ الْمَوْتِ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي لَوْلَا أَخَّرْتَنِي إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ قَرِيبٍ فَأُصَلِّي. No, he didn't say فَأُصَلِّي. I know that. Don't worry, I'll stop here. I'm not proceeding. جَزَى اللَّهُ خَيْرًا. By the way, I cannot make mistakes in ayat. Shouldn't be. جَزَى اللَّهُ خَيْرًا. I shouldn't do that. No, I cannot make mistakes in ayat. Allah didn't say in the ayah, stop here in the ayah, Rabb, oh Allah, return me to pray. Allah, he didn't say that. Allah, don't pray me to fast. He didn't hajj. How about jihad? How about, no, teaching my kids? No, why? فَأَسَّدَّقَ فَأَسَّدَّقَ give وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. صح؟ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. فَأَسَّدَّقَ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. صح؟ فَأَسَّدَّقَ. 2 things. فَأَسَّدَّقَ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ means everything. But Allah put the sadaqah in front. The money you have in your pocket. It's good to enjoy. My son, when I was leaving, he gave the first khutbah and he left. He said, where are you going? He said, I'm going to eat.
he's going to eat outside. Okay.
Plan. Plan, think. It's okay to eat. It's okay to enjoy. It's okay to have fun. But it's better to give something when you go. In any masjid, I'm not out teaching, and I see beautiful faces here. Don't leave without giving $1. I'm not saying much. $1 at least. You put on yourself. No, no, no. Give it your son or daughter. Put this dollar in the box. $1. I'm not saying more. Please. If you can do more, it's good. But $1 in the box. Teaching them. You will take double the hasanat. This is the waladun salih. Teach your son or daughter. By the way, when the Islam said walad means boy or girl. Walad, you teach your son or daughter how to give. How to give charity. How to work with that. The sadaqat is a different khutbah, but teach them how to connect. How to work with Islam. How to give in the sake of Allah. And if you can, sponsor. Sponsor someone. Someone will say, I don't have kids. I'm sorry, Allah didn't give me kids. Alhamdulillah, don't worry. You have a chance. How? Most of the masajid and this masjid have Darul Quran. They have kids who cannot afford to pay for the money. We have here 70 of them. Try to go in and sponsor one. How? Ask outside. This is not the time. Ask outside the brothers. They will tell you. Give. The idea of giving is very important. This is the extra life you can get. Not only the extra life you can get. Think about it that way. It's like a tree. It's not an extra life. It's more than an extra life. I teach my son the dua. I taught you all the dua. 10% of you know the dua. Memorize the dua now. Allahumma ghfirli. I'm repeating because I need more than 10%. I'm smart. Allahumma ghfirli wa li walidayya wa li ashabi al-huquqi alayya. Three things. 10% of you knew it. You taught your kids who weren't here or they were here. Okay? Your kids taught their kids or taught someone else. What happens? I'm taking. Jazakumullah khair. You're passing the hasanat. Be smart. Are you taking? Yes. Because you taught your son and your son taught your brother. He is taking too. Don't worry. Allah is so generous. He wants to give us all the hasanat. He wants to give us Jannah. He built the Jannah for you. Jannah for every one of you. Allah is the most merciful. He loves everyone. Everyone. He wants everyone to go to Jannah. That's why He shows us the easy way to join and to be in Jannah, to be with the Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam. Allahumma ahdina fi man hadayt. Allahumma ahdina fi man hadayt. Wa afina fi man afayt. Wa tawallana fi man tawallayt. Allahumma ajma'na wa la tufarriqna. Oh Allah, make us from the people who go to Jannah. Oh Allah, make us from the people to go to Jannah without questioning, ya Rabbal Alameen. Oh Allah, make our kids and our family from the people to go to Jannah. Oh Allah, make us from the people who have castles in the Jannah. Oh Allah, make us from the people who have trees and heaven and big castles in Jannah. Allahumma aghfir lana wa li walidina wa li ashabi al-huquq alayna wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin qumu ila salatikum yarhamkumullah wa aqimi as-salah.
Allahu akbar. Allah.